As an ex-serviceman, you just have this inherent reserve about discussing your inner feelings.
I didn't want anybody to know about it, and particularly the guys that I'd served with. I don't think, oh, you wimp, Driscoll, you know, we've all been through it. What's the matter with you, you know?
Put on a brave face, be one of the lads, crack on, do the things that soldiers do. But inwardly, we're falling apart.
Depression's not—it's not a dirty word, you know. It's something that people kind of shy away from. But actually, to admit that you're depressed is kind of the first step.
People are reluctant to ask for help. Maybe they think that they don't deserve it, or it's not for them, or it won't help, or it'll be too difficult.
There's a remedy for depression. There's a remedy for anxiety, as long as you're open to it and as long as you're prepared to say, actually, can I please have some help?
A turning point for me was when Prince Harry said, having a mental illness is not a weakness. The weakness is failing to do anything about it.
When I first picked up that phone, although it was very difficult, although it was very scary, it was a massive weight off my mind just to sort of speak to someone that understood exactly where I was and exactly what I was talking about.
My home life, my marriage, my family life, it is much better than it could ever be due to admitting there's something wrong and going to get the treatment. Life couldn't be better.
Seeing him at his most broken, and now seeing him now, it's just amazing.
I know that no matter what, you know, the support is going to be there for me, and I do feel that if I go back and I have those dark days and I am struggling, that all I need to do is pick up the phone.
I know that it's going to take a while, and he's always going to be a work in progress. But my story could have been very different if we hadn't asked for help.